गुड आफ्टरनून वर्चुअल ऑडियंस प्रेजेंटिंग डिजिटली. आई एम वैष्णवी सोनवणे हियर. वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू. बी अ असाइनमेंट प्रेजेंटेशन. बी अ हाफ ऑफ अवर ग्रुप. दिस असाइनमेंट इज गाइडेड बाय मिस वैशाली हरक मॅम. असाइनमेंट इज ऑफ अवर सब्जेक्ट इज बेसिक इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजिनिअरिंग. टॉपिक ऑफ अवर असाइनमेंट इज सोलर थर्मल पॉवर सिस्टम. इन दिस असाइनमेंट we are going to look over the different types of solar thermal power system and how it's actually work, and continue with the help of PowerPoint presentation. Introduction. Solar thermal power generation systems use mirror to collect sunlights and produce steam by solar heat to drive turbines for generating power. This system generates power by rotating turbines like thermal and nuclear power plants, and therefore is suitable from large scale power generation. Solar thermal system works by sun energy and converting into heat energy and transfer into your home and business city. Next, basic working principles. Mirrors reflect and concentrated sunlight. Receivers collect that solar energy and convert it into heat energy. A generator can then be used to produce electricity from this heat energy. Next, solar thermal system. There are two types of solar thermal system. First, passive, and second, active. A passive system requires no equipment, like when heat builds up inside your car when it's left parked in the sun. Example, thermal chimneys. Second, active. An active system requires some way to absorb and collect solar radiation and then store it. Example, solar thermal power plant. Thermal energy storage. In short, TES. TES are high pressure liquid storage tank used along with a solar thermal system to allow plant to bank several hours of potential electricity. To tank directly system, solar thermal energy is stored right in the same heat transfer fluid that collected it. To tank indirectly system functions basically the same as the direct system, except it works with different types of heat transfer fluid. Single tank thermocouple systems store thermal energy as a solid, usually silica sand. Next, types of solar thermal power plants. First, parabolic trough system. Second, solar power tower system. Third, solar dish engine system. And fourth, compact linear Fresnel reflector. First, parabolic trough system. A parabolic trough consists of a linear parabolic reflector that concentrated light onto a receiver potential along the reflector focal line. The receiver is a tube potential directly above the middle of parabolic mirror and filled with a working fluid. The reflector follows the sun during the daylight hours by tracking along a single axis. A working fluid, example molten salt, is heated to 150 degrees Celsius to 350 degrees Celsius as it flows through the receiver and then used as a heat source for a power generation system. This is the diagrammatic representation of parabolic trough system. Next, solar power tower system. Power tower means also known as central tower power plants or holistate power plants. These designs capture and focus the sun's thermal energy with thousands of tracking mirrors called holistate in roughly a 2 square mile field. A tower resides in the center of holistate field. The holistate focuses concentrated sunlight on a receiver which sits on top of the tower. Within the receiver, the concentrated sunlight heats molten salt to over 1000 degree Fahrenheit. The heat molten salt then flows into a thermal storage tank, where it is stored, maintaining 98% thermal efficiency, and eventually pumped to a steam generator. A steam drives a standard turbines to generate electricity. This is the diagrammatic representation of solar power. और इंजन सिस्टम. फॉर अ नेक्स्ट स्लाइड आई रिक्वेस्टेड अ मानसू शिंदे टू टेक ओवर फ्रॉम एक्सप्लेनिंग नेक्स्ट टॉपिक.
थैंक यू वैष्णवी. आई मानसी शिंदे टेक ओवर अ नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. नाउ लेट्स सी नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज सोलर डिश इंजन सिस्टम. द सिस्टम कंसिस्ट ऑफ अ स्टैंड अलोन पैराबोलिक रिफ्लेक्टर दैट कॉन्सेंट्रेट्स लाइट ऑन टू अ रिसीवर पोजिशन एट द रिफ्लेक्टर्स फोकल पॉइंट. द वर्किंग फ्लूइड इन द रिसीवर इज हीटेड टू 250 to 700 degrees Celsius 523 to 973 Kelvin 482 to 1292 degree Farad and then used by a drilling engine to generate power. Parabolic dish system have the highest efficiency of all solar technologies. Provide solar to electric efficiency between 31 to 32%. This is diagrammatic representation of solar dish engine system. Next topic, compact linear Fresnel reflector. First one, linear Fresnel reflector used along the segment of mirrors to focus sunlight onto a fixed absorber located at a common focal point of the reflector. Second one, these mirrors are capable of concentrating the sun's energy to approximately 30 times its normal intensity. Third one, this concentrated energy is transferred through the absorber into some thermal fluid. Fourth one, the fluid then goes through a heat exchanger to power a steam generator. This is the diagrammatic representation of compact linear Fresnel reflector. Next is enclosed parabolic tube. First one, the enclosed parabolic solar thermal system encapsulates the components within a greenhouse like glass house. Second, the glass house protects the components from the element that can negatively impact system reliability and efficiency. Third, lightweight curved solar reflecting mirror are suspended from the ceiling of the glass house by wire. A fourth one, a single axis tracking system positions the mirrors to drive the optimal amount of sunlight. Fifth one, the mirrors concentrate the sunlight and focus it on a network of stainless steel pipes suspended from the glass structure. Sixth one, water is pumped the pipe and boiled to generate steam when intense sun radiation is applied. Why steel pipe also suspended from the glass house structure. Next one, advantages of solar thermal energy. First one, no fuel cost. Second, predictable 24/7 power. Third one, no pollution and global warming effect. Fourth one, using exciting industrial base. Next topic is disadvantages of solar thermal energy. First one, high cost. Second, future technology has a high probability of making CSP obsolete. Third one, ecological and cultural issues. Fourth one, limited locations and size limitations. Fifth one, long gestation time leading to cost overruns. Next is major challenges. The major challenges are the installation cost and energy storage. The costs are still far higher than fossil fuel plants based on unit of the hot water product are often stretched to their limits. Alternative could be phase change material, PCM, or thermochemical materials TCM. In addition to sensible heat, the technologies of latent heat and thermochemical energy storage on their way to becoming very promising solution for the future of solar heating. And next one, conclusion. First one, in the face of global warming, rising fuel cost and an overgrowing demand for energy, energy needs are expected to increase by nearly the equivalent of 335 million barrels of oil per day, mostly for electricity. Second, by concentrating solar energy with reflective material and converting it into electricity, modern solar thermal power plant, if adopted today as an indispensable part of energy generation, may be capable of sourcing electricity to more than 100 million people in the next 20 years, all from one big renewable resource, the sun. Thank you for giving us such a splendid opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you, Vaishali Harak ma'am, for assigning a lovely opportunity and building our teamwork ability. Thank you.